Methimazole is a thionamide antithyroid agent that inhibits the actions of thyroid peroxidase, leading to a reduction in thyroid hormone synthesis and amelioration of hyperthyroidism. In this video, let's find found. What is methimazole? What is methimazole used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking methimazole? How does methimazole work? How to use methimazole? What is methimazole? Thiamazole, also known as methimazole, is a medication used to treat hyperthyroidism. This includes Graves' disease, toxic multinodular goiter, and thyrotoxic crisis. It is taken by mouth. Full effects may take a few weeks to occur. Thiamazole was approved for medical use in the United States in 1950. It is on the World Health Organization's list of essential medicines. It is also available in Europe and Asia. In 2020, it was the 206th most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 2 million prescriptions. What is methimazole used for? In the United States, methimazole is indicated for the treatment of hyperthyroidism in patients with Graves' disease or toxic multinodular goiter for whom thyroidectomy or radioactive iodine therapy are not appropriate treatment options. Methimazole is also indicated for the amelioration of hyperthyroid symptoms in preparation for thyroidectomy or radioactive iodine therapy. In Canada, methimazole carries the above indications and is also indicated for the medical treatment of hyperthyroidism regardless of other available treatment options. Contraindication. Methimazole is contraindicated if there is hypersensitivity to the drug or any of its components. It is relatively contraindicated during pregnancy. Side effects. Black, tarry stools. Bleeding gums. Bleeding under the skin. Bloody or cloudy urine. Burning, crawling, itching, numbness, prickling, pins and needles, or tingling feelings. Chills. Difficulty in breathing. Dizziness or lightheadedness. Pharmacodynamic. Methimazole inhibits the synthesis of thyroid hormones, resulting in an alleviation of hyperthyroidism. Onset of action occurs within 12 to 18 hours, and its duration of action is 36 to 72 hours, likely due to concentration of methimazole and some metabolites within the thyroid gland after administration. Mechanism of action. Methimazole's primary mechanism of action appears to be interference in an early step in thyroid hormone synthesis involving thyroid peroxidase, TPO. However, the exact method through which methimazole inhibits this step is unclear. TPO, along with hydrogen peroxide, normally catalyzes the conversion of iodide to iodine and then further catalyzes the incorporation of this iodine onto the 3 and/or 5 positions of the phenol rings of tyrosine residues in thyroglobulin. These thyroglobulin molecules then degrade within thyroid follicular cells to form either thyroxine, T4, or triiodothyronine, 3, which are the main hormones produced by the thyroid gland. Methimazole may directly inhibit TPO, but has been shown in vivo to instead act as a competitive substrate for TPO, thus becoming iodinated itself and interfering with the iodination of thyroglobulin. Another proposed theory is that methimazole moiety may interact directly with the iron atom at the center of TPO's heme molecule, thus inhibiting its ability to iodinate tyrosine residues. Other proposed mechanisms with weaker evidence include methimazole binding directly to thyroglobulin or direct inhibition of thyroglobulin itself. Half-life. Following a single intravenous bolus injection of 10 mg of methimazole, the T1/2 of the distribution phase was 0.17 hours, and the T1/2 of the elimination phase was 5.3 hours. Dose. Hyperthyroidism. Mild, 15 mg per day, PO divided Q8HR initially. Moderate, 30 to 40 mg/day, PO divided Q8HR initially. Severe, 60 mg per day, PO divided Q8HR initially. Maintenance, 5 to 30 mg/day PO divided Q8HR. Graves' disease. 10 to 20 mg/day PO once, after euthyroidism is achieved, reduce dosage by 50% and administer for 12 to 18 months, may subsequently taper or discontinue if TSH levels are normal. Thyrotoxicosis, off-label. 15 to 20 mg POQ4HR during first day as adjunct to other agents. Reduce frequency to Q-day or Q12HR once patient is stable. Safety advice. It is classified as pregnancy category D medicine. Fetal harm is reported when methimazole is administered to a pregnant woman. If the woman becomes pregnant while taking methimazole or when methimazole is used during pregnancy, the patient should be counseled on the potential risk to the fetus. That's all the information about methimazole we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.